Good morning, everyone. Last class, we discussed about various types of actuators, that is, drive elements, we'll be studying in this unit number 3. I just to give you a recap, after studying the unit 2, that is, signal conditioning elements, in unit 3, we are supposed to learn various types of drives, those are used in mechatronic systems. As you know, we have mechanical drives, we have electrical drives, we have hydraulic drives, we have pneumatic drives, which are used in various mechatronic actuating devices as such. Broadly, we categorize them into mechanical, electrical, hydraulic, and pneumatic. Out of these, we just started the electrical drives part in the last class. We'll move further in the electrical drives, that is, electrical motors can be categorized broadly, as you can see in the slide, into two types of motors, that is, AC motors and DC motors. Under alternating current motors, once again, you have division like synchronous motors and then induction motors. Similarly, on direct current side, you have direct current motors, which two types of motors we'll be studying. First is the brushed motor, and the second is brushless motor. That is BMDC, brushed motor, or BDC, you can also call it as brushed DC motor, or brushless, that is BLDC. So that's how those are given in short form. So broadly, we'll be considering both alternating current motors and DC motors. To begin with, we have brush type DC motors. As you can see in the slide, this I have borrowed from Boulton's book. A DC motor, the basic principle, we already studied it right from our earlier college days. We have studied the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. What did he say? In that, if you have a current carrying conductor, right, which is converted into a loop form, let us say, this is a conductor which is carrying current. That current is supplied through a commutator. You have a ring, a conducting ring, over which these brushes, carbon brushes, are pressed against us. Okay. And through this, I'll be giving the supply voltage to this conducting wire, right? Now, this is a current carrying conductor. What does Faraday's law say? If I have a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. Now, how this magnetic field is produced? By using fixed magnet or field pole magnet having pole, north pole and south pole. Okay, I have a permanent magnet here acting as a stator, right? So it will set up a magnetic field of its own. Now, in that magnetic field, I have a current carrying conductor, which is part of a rotor. What Faraday's law says then, if I have a current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, right? Magnetic field means, if I just show the arrows virtually, the magnetic field will not be appearing as an arrow. Just if I show the lines of magnetic flux, if the current carrying conductor cuts this magnetic lines of flux, which are set up by the stator magnets, if this current carrying conductor interacts with this magnetic field, right, or magnetic lines of flux, right, then an EMF is induced. An EMF is induced. That's what the Faraday's law said. The current carrying conductor, if it is placed in a magnetic field, you have the electromotive force, right? EMF is induced. Okay, that is what the EMF, the Faraday's law said. And that principle is used for generation purposes, let us say. In this motor case, if I have a conductor, let me correct it, the Faraday's law. If I just keep, forget about this part, in case of generation, if I just keep conducting wire, and if I allow it, if I rotate, or if I allow this current, conducting wire to cut the magnetic lines of flux, in that case, an EMF is induced across these two wires. That's what the Faraday's law says. That is the generation part. In the motor part, what we do? We supply the current. We supply the current in case of motor. We supply the current to this conducting wire. In the generation case, the EMF was induced. There was no current carrying conductor as such in generation. When we discussed about the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Right here in motor case, I am having a conducting wire which is supplied with some voltage, right? Once I supply some voltage across it through the brushes, right? Through the brushes and through this commutator, then once the current starts flowing through this conducting wire, what will happen? The current carrying conductor will set up its own magnetic field as well, isn't it? A small magnetic field around it. And when this own rotor magnetic field interacts with this stator magnetic field, what happens is we have the force that is developed across this coil. Let us call this current carrying conductor is converted into the form of a coil, right? The winding coil. What happens is, here in case of motor, the motor, once the button is put on, the motor should rotate on its own, isn't it? This is what is the motor principle. So what I'm doing, I'm supplying voltage across this conducting wire, and I have on the stator, through the stator, I have the magnetic field that is set up. Now, right. The interaction of the magnetic field of the conducting wire and the magnetic field that I already have through this stator, what happens is a tangential force is developed across each coil, across this coil, a coil of conducting wire, and it will develop a couple, right? And thereafter, the motor will start rotating, right? So this is what is the principle of DC motor, right? And if I go on increasing the pairs of poles, I can develop more and more torque. Here, as you can see, I have a field coil or the stator, and this is the rotor part or armature part. And these are, here it was a single conductor that is shown. If I have number of conductors on the armature, on the rotor, so to say, and if I got more pairs of magnets, here only one magnetic pair is shown. Like that, if I got two pairs, right, I can have 8 pairs, right? I can go on increasing the number of poles, right? So what will happen is each conductor will be developing a tangential force across the coil, and the motor starts rotating, right? I consider a permanent magnet DC motor, the permanent magnet giving a constant value of flux density. For an armature conductor of length L, if the length of the conductor is L, carrying a current I, the force resulting from a magnetic flux density B at right angles to the conductor is force that is developed, the tangential force that I told you, the force that is developed is the product of flux density B, current intensity I, into length of the conductor. This force is equal to BIL. The force results in a torque, right? This force, tangential force, like this, one arrow, like this, one arrow, right? This torque, this tangential force is acting at a distance of R, right? Or let us say this distance here, I am calling it as the breadth of the coil B. Right, the breadth of the coil B. So this force into the perpendicular distance is B, will be the torque, right? So this is the force into the perpendicular distance, that is B. The BLI into B will give you the torque on the armature turn, each of the armature turn. So this is the torque that is developed by each of the armature turn. T is equal to BLI, that is the force, into breadth of the coil, width of the coil, that is small b, right? Capital B is magnetic flux density, right? I is current in amperes. Flux density is Weber per meter square. I is amperes and length L is meters, right? Into breadth B also will be in the in meters. Okay, whatever unit we are considering for length, that can be considered for breadth as well. So the torque on a armature turn would be T is equal to BLI into B or BBLI, right? This is the principle of brushed DC motor. The same is shown in the form of a sectional diagram, right? Whatever just we discussed, BLI into small b, small width is small b. Here it is, the flux density B, current is I, and the width, breadth is small b, right? So this is a split ring commutator, and the supply is given to the coil through some external DC power supply, right? And I have got the permanent magnets N and S. This is the armature, this is the stator, and this is the rotor, right? The same diagram, each coil will experience a tangential force F acting at a perpendicular distance B, and which is cutting the magnetic lines of flux, whose flux density is given by capital B, right? And the I is the current flowing, right? So in the line diagram, it is clear now. So the torque developed will be force into perpendicular distance, that is F into small b. What is F? F is equal to B, flux density B, capital B, into L, length of the coil, into I, that is current. So BLI will give me a force, and the perpendicular distance is B. So BLI into small b gives me the torque developed by this DC motor. The diagram shows forces on the armature. Likewise, I'll be having number of coils, right, mounted on the rotor, on the armature, so to say. Each one of it is given a supply voltage, and each coil is given different supply voltage. How? By through a split. There is a split, as you can see. Those are separated out, right? This is split ring, right? This is split. This is one conductor. Likewise, I'll have another pair of conductors. I'll be having one more conductor, right? And each one will be separated through an insulator, right? So constructionally, it is like this. Now, if we just draw the circuit diagram for that, right? I have this representation as the motor representation. Okay. Sometimes I write M also inside that. And this is, let us say, the armature controlled DC motor, right? This is the equivalent circuit for this motor, equivalent electrical circuit for this motor. This is the armature, these are the brushes through which the voltage is supplied, right? So this is the armature controlled DC motor, and the windings, the coil windings, we just calculated the force and torque here. Electrically speaking, the conducting wire will have, the winding will have, which is made up of conducting wire, it will have resistance R, and it will have the magnetizing property, that is inductance L, right? So this is the equivalent diagram for this motor, right? And what happens? I'm supplying voltage through the brushes to the rotor, right? And the conducting wire has some finite resistance and finite inductance. So because of that, just now I told you, there'll be how the motor starts rotating, as the magnetic field set up by this each conductor interacts with the field, magnetic field, there'll be the tangential force, there'll be this tangential force, and there'll be torque that is developed by this rotor. Now, once this rotor starts rotating, what happens? See what it is doing now? This rotating conductor, once again, it is cutting the magnetic field. येते का लक्षात सुरुवातीला काय होतं ही कॉइल स्टेशनरी आहे काय केलं मी अशी स्टेशनरी आहे इट इज जस्ट आयडल शांत बसली आहे अक्रॉस अँड इट इज केप्ट इन अ स्टेटर मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड मग काय होणार आहे वन्स आय सप्लाय दिस कंडक्टिंग वायर सम सप्लाय वोल्टेज द करंट स्टार्ट फ्लोईंग अँड करंट कॅरिंग कंडक्टर राईट द करंट कॅरिंग कंडक्टर विल सेट अप इट्स ओन मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड right it will set up its own magnetic field now that magnetic field interacts with field magnetic field and tyamulo kay zala this tangential force is developed and the torque is developed hey torque ashe anek maje conductor coils ahet each one will develop its own force right and it will develop the torque and this motor or the rotor or the armature will start rotating mahe rotate vala mhanlantar each of the conductors will start कटिंग द मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड कुठलं मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड कट करणार हे परमनंट मॅग्नेट आहे इट इज सेटिंग अप द मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड इट स्टार्ट कटिंग द मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड मग काय होणार आहे देर बी अ सॉर्ट ऑफ बॅक EMF दॅट इज डेव्हलप दॅट इज गिव्हन बाय VB दिस इज द सप्लाय वोल्टेज अँड दिस इज द बॅक EMF बॅक EMF कशामुळे व्हायला वन्स द मोटर स्टार्ट रोटेटिंग इट विल डेव्हलप बॅक EMF राईट सो इफेक्टिव्हली वोल्टेज किती असणार आहे माझं दिस V मायनस VB राईट दिस विल बी द इफेक्टिव्ह वोल्टेज दॅट इज and this is how electrical circuit is drawn so briefly we'll see what are the torque speed characteristics of this dc motor torque on y axis and speed rotational speed on the x axis I'll be having different supply voltage values for one voltage let us say 30 volts let us say it will show this characteristic mhanje kay hote as the speed of the rotor increases look at this line as the speed of the rotor increases the torque decreases maybe at 2000 rpm this much torque is there at 3000 rpm this much torque is there at 4000 rpm this much torque so I'll be having a dropping torque as the speed increases so speed and torque are inversely related right with increasing speed the torque decreases so this is at one supply voltage at another supply voltage of 60 volt let us say 60 volt dc I'll get another torque speed characteristic right at higher voltage supply voltage at 2000 rpm I might get maybe some 100 newton meter of torque higher torque and as the speed goes on increasing the torque decreases while selecting the motor for my particular application I need to decide what is the optimum value of torque at what rpm I want how much torque that I need to decide and accordingly I should select appropriate motor right so that part we'll discuss later this is how it is selected even aapla IC engine madhe pan if you just go through the engine brochure they give you the speed torque characteristic kiti engine cha rpm la how much torque it is developing right it should not so happen that the optimum torque la aapla bakiche designs jar nahi kele tar what will happen with increasing speed the torque will keep on decreasing ते आपल्याला अपेक्षित नाही आहे त्याप्रमाणे माय गियर डिझाईन्स आर बेस्ड ऑन दिस ऑप्टिमम टॉर्क दॅट इज डेव्हलप्ड बाय द आयसी इंजिन राईट द कन्सेप्ट रिमेन्स द सेम इथं पण डिसे वेल सिलेक्टिंग द डीसी मोटर ऑल्सो आय नीड टू गोईंग फॉर द ऑप्टिमम व्हॅल्यू माझा आरपीएम किती मला ठेवायचं आहे ॲट वॉट आरपीएम हाऊ मच टॉर्क आय वॉन्ट वन्स आय डिसाईड दॅट मग त्या आरपीएमला तेवढा टॉर्क देणार असे अनेक कर्ज मला मिळतील वेगवेगळ्या मोटरसाठी जे मग त्यातली कुठली मोटर मला पाहिजे तो टॉर्क दॅट आरपीएम देते दॅट मोटर आय नीड टू सिलेक्ट दिस इज हाऊ दीज डीसी मोटर कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स कुठलाही पंप असू दे मोटर असू दे इंजिन असू दे ह्याच्यावरनं तर बेसिक ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दीज कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ओनली वी सिलेक्ट अप्रोप्रिएट ड्राईव्ह फ्लेअर अँड फर्दर इन ब्रश टाईप डीसी मोटर आय हॅव गॉट व्हरायटी ऑफ टाईप्स नाव राईट ॲज अ टोल्ड यू दिस इज आर्मेचर कॉईल हे ब्रशेस दाखवले म्हणजे हे आर्मेचर कॉईल आहे आणि मग त्याला फील्ड वाइंडिंग आहे जे आता मी सांगितलं इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेट जर असेल मी मगाशी दाखवला होता दॅट वॉज अ परमनंट मॅग्नेट साधा मॅग्नेट जो मॅग्नेटाईज केलेला आहे तो दाखला टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रिंसिपल. बट इफ दैट मैग्नेट बिकम्स ऑपरेशन, मला असं डिझाईन करायचं आहे की जो तो मॅग्नेट सप्लाय व्होल्टेज दिल्यानंतरच त्याच्यात मॅग्नेटिझम डेव्हलप व्हायचा, इफ दॅट इज माय रिक्वायरमेंट, वॉट आय नीड टू डू, इन्स्टेड ऑफ परमनंट मॅग्नेट आय नीड टू हॅव इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेट. इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेट, व्हॉट इज द मिनिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेट? द सप्लाय व्होल्टेज इज गिव्हन टू दॅट स्टेटर मॅग्नेट, देन ओनली इट विल बी एनर्जाइज अँड इट विल बी सेटिंग अप मॅग्नेट, राईट? सो दॅट इज इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेट, राईट? बोथ द टाइप्स आर यूज फॉर continuous drive action. I prefer electromagnets, right? So whenever I don't require a torque to be developed, I can just stop the supply voltage to the field coils. So basically I have armature windings, I have field windings, right? Now in the DC motors, I got, as I told you, variety of types: series motors, shunt motors, compound motors, and separately wound or separately excited motor, right? आता हे तीन टाइप्स इथे दाखवले. फर्स्ट इज सिरीज. कशाला सिरीज म्हणायचं? सिरीज टाइप ब्रश्ड डीसी मोटर. वेन, लिसन टू बी व्हेरी केअरफुली, वेन द फील्ड कॉइल इज इन सिरीज विथ आर्मेचर कॉइल, फील्ड कॉइल इज इन सिरीज विथ द आर्मेचर कॉइल, इट इज कॉल्ड एज सिरीज वाउंड डीसी मोटर. वेन द फील्ड कॉइल इज इन पॅरलल विथ द आर्मेचर कॉइल, it is called as shunt type of DC motors. And if I got combination of series and shunt, that is called as compound type of DC motor, right? Each one of these motors, series, shunt, and compound, will have various speed torque characteristics. So based on that, I need to select appropriate motor. How? I'll tell you that. Now, in this case, compound wound DC motor, I have got both series winding, one winding is in series and the other winding is in, other field winding is in shunt, in parallel. And then I have got no series shunt business, I have got separately excited. Manje maza armature winding la separate voltage dilela ani field winding la separate voltage dile. Itha kay, there is a common supply voltage, right? That is shared both by armature and the field. Here I have got separate excitation for armature, separate excitation for field, right? So this is separately excited DC motor, separately excited DC motor. Now each one of it has got different speed torque characteristics. Mag jasa magashi manalo mi, I need to decide what is my speed and torque requirement. Let us say for one particular application, I'm not interested in lower speed range, but I want maximum torque at a given higher speed. Maybe 4000 RPM la mala maximum torque pahije. Ata out of these three motors, series wound, compound wound, shunt motor, sab let us say 4000 is here. 4000 mala maximum torque kutli motor dete out of series, compound and shunt? The shunt motor is giving me maximum torque. Current at 4000 RPM, series motor gives me lower. Even compound motor also gives me little higher than series, but compared to shunt, it is giving me lower torque. If such is the requirement, I shall go in for shunt wound DC motor. But in sometimes, I want high torque at lower RPM. Mag I can go in for either series wound motor or compound wound motor instead of shunt wound, because at lower RPM, I don't get the requisite torque itself in shunt motor. So in that case, I'll go in for either series wound motor or compound motor. So these characteristics are supplied by the manufacturer, the specifications are supplied, but the catalogs are stuck, and based on that, depending on my speed torque requirement, I need to select appropriate motor for my mechatronic system actuation, right? So what are the advantages and limitations of a brushed DC motor? Remember, we're discussing brushed DC motor. What are the advantages? The design of the brush DC motor is quite simple. Controlling the speed of a brush DC motor is easy, relatively easy. It is very cost effective. But what are the limitations of brushed DC motor? It has got high maintenance. Kashamula asu shakelo high maintenance. But there's constant friction between the commutator and the brush. The brushes are pressed against the कम्युटेटर रिंग कार्बन ब्रशेस दोज आर इन कॉन्टैक्ट विथ द स्प्लिट कम्युटेटर राइट विच इज गॉट कंडक्टिंग वायर कोटिंग और कंडक्टिंग कॉपर कोटिंग एज सच सो दैट दोज आर इन कॉन्स्टेंट टच एंड कॉन्स्टेंट फ्रिक्शन एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट एक देर विल बी मोर वेयर एंड टेयर ऑफ द मोटर ऑफ द ब्रशेस एंड इवन ऑफ द कम्युटेटर सर्फेस मते पीरियडिकली आई नीड टू क्लीन अप फॉर द कार्बन पार्टिकल्स आणि मग कॉन्टैक्ट रेजिस्टन्स पण दिस इज ऑल्सो वन मोर इश्यू इन केस ऑफ ब्रश मोटर्स कॉन्टैक्ट रेजिस्टन्स मोर देयर विल बी वोल्टेज ड्रॉप सो इट रिक्वायर्स फ्रिक्वेंट मेंटेनन्स द परफॉर्मन्स डिक्रीजेस विथ डस्ट पार्टिकल आता कार्बन पार्टिकल जेव्हा फ्रिक्शन मुळे जे ब्रश मधून सेपरेट होतील दोज विल गेट डिपॉझिटेड ऑन द रोटर राईट So those will pose some problems that will decrease the performance. Less reliable in control at lower speeds. As we have seen the characteristics, it is less reliable in control of lower speeds. The brushes wear off with usage. So these are the limitations of brushed DC motor. So what is the brushless type of permanent magnet DC motors? Let us see quickly. Brush type, what is the stator was having permanent magnets and rotor was having the current carrying conductors here in brushless type permanent magnet DC motors the permanent magnets are on the rotor as against in brush type motor the permanent magnets were on the stator here in brushless type of permanent magnet DC motors the magnets are on the rotor whereas I have the field windings right or the armature windings are on the stator kitha ka hota armature windings were on the rotor and the permanent magnets were on the stator in case of brushed type of dc motor permanent magnet dc motor in brushless type of permanent magnet dc motors it is exactly opposite the permanent magnets are on the rotor and the armature coils are on the stator here also you can find out the pairs A1 and A2 or A positive and A negative, B positive and B negative, C positive and C negative. So these are four pairs, right? And then this brushless motor, DC motor, has a rotor with permanent magnet and stator with winding. The rotor can be of ceramic permanent magnet type. The brushes and the commutator are eliminated and the windings are connected to the control electronics. The control electronics replaces the commutator and the brushes. And energizes the stator sequentially. मला जी अँग्युलर पोझिशन पाहिजे ती पेअर A1 A2 तरी करेन नंतर C1 C2 करेन मे बी नंतर B1 B2 करेन ॲज पर माय अँग्युलर पोझिशन रिक्वायरमेंट आय विल बी एनर्जायझिंग ईच ऑफ दीज पेअर्स ऑफ द वाइंडिंग ऑन द स्टेटर म्हणजे काय झालं हे सिक्वेन्शियली मग तिथे मी ट्रान्झिस्टर्स वापरेन स्विचिंग सर्किट वापरेन सो दॅट इन सिक्वेन्स दीज स्टेटर वाइंडिंग आर एनर्जाइज म्हणजे सो टू से काय होणार हे आणि हे नंतर हे आणि हे आणि नंतर हे आणि हे सिक्वेन्शियली एक थोडासा टाइम गॅपने मी एनर्जाइज करत गेलं तर आय विल बी सो टू से डेव्हलपिंग अ रोटेटिंग मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड मग रोटेटिंग मॅग्नेटिक फील्डमुळे काय होणार बिकॉज ऑफ दिस रोटेटिंग मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड this rotor with permanent magnets will be dragged along with this rotating magnetic field and the motor starts rotating right the current supply to the stator is based on the position of the rotor it is switched in sequence using transistors the position of the rotor is sensed by Hall effect sensors which you already studied this continuous rotation is obtained how because of this rotating magnetic field the rotor permanent magnets also rotate and I get continuous motion of the rotor this the same thing whatever I discussed with the brushless permanent magnet DC motor the reverse is the case the current carrying conductors are fixed and the magnet moves next the same thing in elaborated manner I have shown the transistors how they develop the sequential switching फक्त एक sequence बघूया रोटर पोझिशन 0 डिग्रीला असेल तर माझा हॉल इफेक्ट सेन्सर मला पोझिशन सांगणार A position of winding A, position of winding B, position of winding F of A, B, C. What are the positions? मतलब zero degree position पाइजे. So what I want, what I'll do, I want to energize simply C, right? C coil वाला energize करायचे. मग त्यावेळेला काय करायला लागेल मला? I should make the transistor A plus and transistor B minus on. Transistor A plus and B minus on केला, तर I'll get the zero degree position. If I want 60 degree position, I'll energize transistor A plus, transistor A plus. Go back. Transistor A plus. Transistor A plus ani C minus. Similarly for 120 degree, I'll be energizing transistor B plus and C minus. Similarly, I'll be sequentially switching those windings on the stator. म्हणजे काय होईल? Time lapse नंतर एक एक winding energize होत जाईल and I'll be developing a rotating magnetic field and the rotor will start rotating. This is how my brushless type of permanent magnet DC motor works. What quickly we'll see what are the advantages and limitations. The advantages of brushless DC motor: it is more precise due to computer control, it is more efficient, no sparking due to absence of brushes, there is less electrical noise involved in this, no brushes to wear out, electromagnets are situated on the stator, hence easy to cool, right? Motor can operate at speeds above 10,000 RPM under loaded and unloaded conditions. Responsiveness and quick acceleration due to low rotor inertia is possible. Right? The permanent magnet, brush type DC motor मध्ये काय होतं? सगळ्या रोटर वरच्या कॉइल्स जे आहेत, वाइंडिंग आहेत, those were making the rotor bulky. त्यामुळे हायर इनर्शिया, मतलब रोटर रोटेट करायला आई वॉज रिक्वायरिंग मोर टॉर्क, राईट, ऑफ द फील्ड वाइंडिंग, राईट. इथं काय होणार आहे? आय ओनली हॅव a pair of magnets, I don't have any coils, right? Winding coils nahi hai, conductors nahi hai tithe, tyamule it is lighter, so low inertia. So these are the advantages of my brushless DC motor. Similar limitations: what are the limitations? Higher initial cost of brushless DC motor, these are complex due to presence of computer controller. Brushless DC motors also require additional system wiring in order to power the electronic commutation circuit. So these are the limitations of brushless DC motors. But in present era, brushless DC motors are more in use. Apan ja bikes, chota chota e-bikes vagare bakto, they are using brushless DC motors only. These are preferred because of inherent advantages. Just now we study. I think, friends, we are running short of time. We'll stop here.